I have to ask what it was like working with one of the greatest directors of all time in Mr. Steven Spielberg. Well, that must be quite a special experience, even amongst all the great people you have worked with.
Yeah, it's incredible. It's that thing, it's a cliche, getting the call from Spielberg. It's that thing that you go, of course I'll do that like low-budget theatre job with you, unless I get the call from Spielberg. And I got the call from Spielberg, which is, you know, it's incredible. So it was an incredible feeling, and it lived up to everything that I could have ever wanted. He was an amazing director. He was personal, wonderful, supportive, and just epic. He's an amazing man.
Obviously, I mean, your scene with Ty is kind of a bit of an emotional moment for the film, really, because it really defines where his character's coming from, and it's one of the darker moments, I guess, in an otherwise quite escapist film. Can you talk a little bit about working on that kind of material?
Yeah, he's... I think that's the thing. He's a horrible... The character I play, he's an idiot. He's a horrible man, but he's a part of the world that Ty Wade Watts is living in. That's his day-to-day reality, and that's what makes the Oasis so powerful to him, is the fact that his day-to-day life is living with an idiot like Rick that I play. Yeah. I had some experience with some horrible bullies as a young man, you know. I've watched these people work, and I think being 6'2" with a big broken nose and a gravelly voice means that you're slightly geared towards those kind of parts. But yeah, I think I've experienced a lot of bullying in my life, and I hope that helps me play those parts better, you know?
Rick pours himself into the XO1 special suit. Can you talk a little bit about what it was like slipping one of those on? Would you be doing that in real life if that was an option when you're playing games?
I've got my son over your shoulder, and he's nodding madly, like, yeah, of course I would. No, I wouldn't. No, it involves olive oil. It involves about three people pulling that suit over you. It's the most undignified thing you could ever imagine, getting into one of those suits.
I mean, we talked a little bit about those scenes you had with Ty, but I think obviously Ty is a very exciting young actor. Can you talk about the qualities that you think he has that makes him such a great young leading man?
What he has is that he works. He works really hard. He learns all the time. We were doing a scene, and I love to watch camera crews work. I still like to learn everything I can about lenses, about all the new technology that's coming out. I think that the more you learn as an actor technically, the better performer you'll become. And Ty was sat there at one point as I was watching the camera crew, and he was FaceTiming one of his friends in Texas, one of his old mates. And his mate went, "What are you doing?" And he turned his FaceTime camera around and went, "Watching and learning." And he just turned it around at the camera crew. You know, a lot of young starlets would have been in their trailer, playing Xbox or whatever. But he was on set, watching the camera crew set up the shot to learn. And I think that's why he will be one of the great, great actors.